What does the term event-driven mean? In this video, I will briefly explain five patterns that fall under the umbrella of event-driven architecture because they use events as their main driver. Hi, I'm Daniel Tamajay, head architect with over 15 years of experience in designing and developing event-driven distributed systems. Now, the first pattern I will explain is event notification, which is using events as a notification mechanism between multiple systems. This approach enables components to plug on and subscribe to event streams with little effort, simplifying the addition of new consumers. Depending on the middleware, all registered consumers would be notified to trigger actions whenever an event occurs. However, this pattern can impact performance and availability because events under the event notification pattern do not carry state. Therefore, downstream components depend on the source systems for information. The second pattern, event carried state transfer, is a pattern that builds on the event notification pattern by replicating all the data that downstream systems may need from the source system to avoid calling back. This approach can help improve performance and availability as downstream systems no longer depend on the source system for state. However, it can also lead to potential consistency issues because 1. An event state could be stale by the time a consumer processes the event data, and 2. Due to the nature of latency in distributed systems, we have eventual data consistency. The third pattern, Cqrs, Command Query Responsibility Segregation, is a pattern that involves separating the processing of commands or events that update entities from the processing of queries. This approach can help improve performance and scalability, allowing different processing pipelines to be optimized for their specific tasks. The idea is to use a separate process for read and write operations, each optimized for their specific task. The write process is typically used to create, update, and delete objects and is optimized for consistency, while the read model is used to query the state and is tuned for performance. By separating the two, Cqrs can help improve scalability as the read and write models can be scaled independently. However, it can also lead to increased complexity as there are now two separate pipelines to manage. The fourth pattern is a pattern that involves creating an immutable activity log of all the events that change the state of business objects. This pattern treats events as the source of truth for the system or objects by deriving the state from the stream of events. Instead of storing and maintaining the current state of the system or objects at all times. Unlike the Command Query Responsibility Segregation pattern, Cqrs, which supports the full range of CRUD, create, read, update, and delete against objects, event sourcing pattern only supports create and update in the sense that rather than making changes to object records, you create a record in a log, just like a finance ledger. These events, these log records, can be replayed to reconstruct the system's current state at any point in time. Now, the purists will tell you that using the event logs to build and maintain temporary, long-term materialized views, or even local copies of data for quick access, goes against the concept of event sourcing. However, in my view, as architects, you do whatever you need to do in order to meet your performance, reliability and scalability requirements. Building state from an event log on request can be costly. Use all the tools at your disposal. Now, event sourcing allows for greater flexibility and scalability as copies of data can be rebuilt from the log at any time. Also, it provides a complete audit trail of all changes, which can be useful in certain scenarios, such as compliance requirements, financial audit. However, implementing it can be complex as it requires careful consideration of how events are logged and how the application or object state is derived from them. But do not mistake event sourcing for event streaming. The two are completely different. Now the fifth pattern is event sourcing. Now I originally intended to discuss event streaming under the second pattern, event carried state transfer. However, event streaming is a pattern in its own right and requires its own mention. I think of event carried state transfer as the concept of a process or system handing the baton over to another process or system, while event streaming is the mindset to take when architecting or chronographing a low latency, near real-time data processing pipeline. For example, the triggering of a single purpose function or functions that process, filter and split events downstream. And the industry uses event streaming for financial data processing, fraud detection and monitoring, to say the least. Event streaming often gets confused with event sourcing because both require a stream or a log of immutable events that is retained for a certain time period. And in my experience, enabling one enables the other. However, they are not the same, because event streaming opens up connectivity and allows events to reach multiple destinations by allowing multiple functions, services and systems to consume an event stream and process the events independently to drive their processing. Now, in event streaming, an event state is stale as it flows through the pipeline, whereas event sourcing purpose is to ensure that the state of an entity is kept up to date by using the events. I have heard the following to describe the difference. Event sourcing is data at rest, while event streaming is data in motion. Now, go check out the video comparing the difference between two types of middleware, which enable event-driven architecture, event streams, and message brokers.